This is Shivkumar Sharma, and I am a Santoor player, and I have been involved with this art form for the past 60 years or more than that. Santoor was originally known as Shata Tantri Veena. This is a Sanskrit word. Shata in Sanskrit language means 100, Tantri means strings, and Veena was a common word for all kind of string instruments. Today when we say Veena, we think of a particular instrument. But Veena was a common word in Sanskrit language, and we had different forms and shapes and styles of Veena, like Rudra Veena, Pinaki Veena, Naradiya Veena, Tumbaru Veena, Ban Veena, Shatatantri Veena, Rudra Veena, Saraswati Veena. So this is the same instrument, Shatatantri Veena, a 100-stringed Veena, which got its present name very, very later on afterwards, many centuries after that. And the name was Santoor. There's another theory that this instrument, Shatatantri Veena, traveled along with the gypsies from India to the European countries. And they gave their own names and changed the instrument according to the requirements of their music. That is a different subject altogether. Now I'll come back to Santoor in Kashmir. Many people still keep on repeating this, that I brought Santoor from Kashmiri folk music to the Indian classical music. The fact is, Santoor is not a Kashmiri folk instrument. Santoor is used in Sufiana Mausiki. What is Sufiana Mausiki? A poetry which speaks about Sufi philosophy, and they sing it. And there are influences of Persian music in that. For example, in Persian music, they call it, we call rag, and they have got a different name for that, which is equivalent of rag. But in Sufi music, the names they have got, sometimes they are similar to Indian ragas. But the scale is different. Now, when we talk about comparison of Indian classical music and Persian music, the placement of the swaras, notes, and microtones are different as compared to Indian classical notes or scale. So in Kashmiri Sufiana Mausiki, we have got scale equivalent to Indian classical music and not to Persian music. That is major difference. And as I said, we call rag and they call it makam. So now in Kashmir, how they present this music, this was in smaller, places where Sufi saint is sitting, some of his devotees and singers who sing in praise of God Almighty. And Sufi philosophy is a great philosophy. And poetry is in Kashmiri language or in Persian language. Now, Santoor is used as an accompanying instrument in Sufi music in Kashmir, along with the singers. And sometimes the same singer who's playing the Santoor is also singing. Sufi music came from the, dargahs of Sufi saints to the radio stations. And they started broadcasting from Srinagar radio. And then how people came to know about this music. Now, another very interesting factor about this music is Sufiana Mausiki. The percussion instrument they use is tabla. And they also call it their own tals. But suppose same beats and a name of the tal have got different beats in Sufiana Mausiki as compared to Indian classical music. So what I mean to say is, this Sufiana Mausiki in Kashmir was influenced by Indian classical music. Kashmiri poetry, Persian poetry, and Iranian, Persian words like maqam. So it's a combination of both cultures and traditions.